Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani, and today I'm talking about Kybella and the five pitfalls that both clinics and some patients experience with the product and the results. Over time, it's been difficult for patients to accept the product and also practices. I'm gonna go through why that is. I'm actually a big fan of Kybella. I love using it, but let's go through the five pitfalls, starting with number one, and that is not using enough product. Now, the grid was developed and we say to inject 0.2 mLs per spot on the grid, so it keeps it simple, but there's been a problem with people getting partial treatments. And we did a whole video that you can look up on our site regarding results and how much product it actually takes, but that is probably the number one pitfall. Number two is swelling. This is very difficult for both the injectors and the patients. It typically, to the patient, can last for 2 to 3 weeks. They can see it for certain, but to observers looking at the patients, what's interesting, independent observers would say it lasts anywhere from 2 to 6 days. This conversation with everything we do, whether it's lasers or fillers, when people ask about downtime, is a loaded question. What may be downtime to me is absolutely no downtime to somebody else. So we're always getting an idea and a feel for our patients and their expectations, but embrace the swelling. Why? We don't see loose skin very much at all with Kybella. We see skin tightening. I believe it's the inflammation that's caused by the swelling that's creating the skin tightening. So we need to embrace the swelling. Number three, the argument's always made, why don't I just have surgery? There's definitely patients that need surgery, and maybe half of the patients that walk in may be better surgical candidates, but I make the argument, why have surgery? For those in whom the treatment is appropriate for, think about it. They don't have to have a surgical procedure. It's an add-on procedure. You can fine tune, you can treat the jawline, and you can kind of really create beauty over time. With a surgical procedure, it's one and done, and many people don't want to have surgery. So I say, I would pay a premium not to have surgery. The number four pitfall, and this is part in the development of the product. Having that grid does make it easy to do. It's standard, reproducible, it's great for a trial, but what's great for a trial and what happens in trials often isn't anything close to what we do in practice. We all know that. But the grid was for submental fat. How we use it now, of course, there's off-label, off-body, but talking about the face, certainly areas on the face that you can treat, the jowl. The jowl was treated in the trial, but the facial downturn of the mouth was not. So we have data on this. More importantly is the jawline and lateral treatment. Why not treat lateral where the grid does not go? That creates beauty. It takes less product. And just treating the submentum where the grid shows you to treat can be an unusual result too, because we're just getting rid of the fat here and it works so well in many patients that the fat's gone from the submentum, but it's not gone from the jawline. So sculpting the jawline and the lack of it is number four in the pitfall. Pitfall number five, only treating once. So we know from the trials that most of the patients had 4 to 6 treatments. But yet around the country, the majority of patients have had one single treatment, and that leads to no results. So not having enough treatment sessions. Now we deviate from the trial in this case. Why? If we know that most people had 4 to 6 sessions, why are most people having one session? Several factors go into this. Number one is people shop around. There's a certain cost for permanent fat reduction under the chin, and to reduce that cost and try and treat people once and see what response they get or see if they're happy with the result is a setup for failure. We need to follow the trial here. There certainly are patients that in one treatment are gonna get a great result, or two treatments. Those are the outliers, and while they happen and we rejoice over those, the majority need several treatment sessions. So be honest and upfront about what it's gonna take. There's some variability in the product. Some people do treat quicker, some take longer, and there are some that don't respond. The trial, 80% of the people were happy. That means 20% may not. We may need more treatments for them or higher doses. So there's your five pitfalls for Kybella. I hope that helps. It's a great product. I love it. I use it in many different ways. Get training on it if you haven't had training on it before. Start to think outside of the box. There will be new grids coming that will help treat laterally and help with these pitfalls over time and help us get the product giving the results that it really can deliver. Thanks for joining me today. Join us on this YouTube channel, on Instagram, and on Facebook for continued helpful tips. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.